Hey guys, this is StuMurray47 here, back with another Superman-related review. And in today's review, guys, I'm going to be reviewing... Essentially, it's a Superman and Supergirl 2-pack that was actually released back in 2010. So it wasn't released too long ago. Now, since I've just done my Return of Supergirl, or the Supergirl from Krypton review series, I thought I'd tack this one on. This is actually from my good friend Chapman Films. I was doing a review of a Supergirl statue a while back and remarked that I had an action figure that looked just like the statue, and he said he'd never seen it, so this is for him. Basically, what happened was, of course, in the actual line that was released from DC Direct in 2006, they, of course, released 5 figures, one of which was Superman, one of which was Supergirl. Now... 4 years later, they actually reissued the 2 same body sculpts. However, well, and this with the Superman is the exact same body entirely, including the same head. But Supergirl was different. They gave her a brand new head sculpt, a much better head sculpt, and a much better paint job. Overall, the paint scheme of these 2 figures is much darker than the original versions, and in my opinion, these figures are much better all round. So, I don't know if you noticed, but the actual Supergirl head sculpt is much more accurate to the animated movie that came out. There was actually an animated movie that came out called Superman Batman Apocalypse, and of course that was based on the storyline that came from the Supergirl from Krypton comic storyline. The animated movie is really great, guys. If you get a chance to see it, you know, please do, because it really is quite faithful to the book. It changes quite a few aspects, but the animation is great, the story is really good, and this is what Supergirl looks like. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to give you a quick 360 of the 2 figures, and I'm just going to review them individually and compare, you know, them with the originals. So here is the 360. So as you can see, just like the original figures, they are practically the same height. In the book, well, you can see Supergirl's ever so slightly shorter, but I think in the book she's meant to be considerably shorter. I really do like this much darker paint scheme. The original one, which I'll show you, was a bright, bright red, and this is more of a muted kind of Superman Returns style colour. And Supergirl looks much better. The skin tone, the colour of the costume, the S on the chest, the hair looks so much better than they did with the original figure. So what I'm going to do, guys, just obviously give you a chance to see them all there, 360. What I'm going to do is I'll just move Supergirl out of the way, and I'm just going to do a quick review of the Superman figure. So if you watched my review a few days ago, or depending on when you watched it, it was the original released figure, which came from 2006. Now this figure is practically identical in every way with regards to sculpt. What you're going to find, of course, is that... I'll just bring him a bit closer. Oh yeah, and just before I do that, guys, here's the base he comes on. It's just a standard DC Direct black disc, which, to be honest, I love these. They don't take up much space. They're very simple. Obviously, just one little peg stand there. And whilst that I do like some of the big, larger Superman S bases, they're very cumbersome. They take up a lot of room, whereas these ones are just kind of subtle. So here's the figure in a bit more detail. Now, he does have the same issue with his eyes that the original release had, where his eyes look too far apart and they look like they're looking 2 different directions, but I can forgive that. It's a minor detail, to be honest. He still has the really, really big chin that obviously sticks out quite far there, which is very noticeable. It is kind of accurate to the art. What I'm going to do, I did this on the previous review, but here's a shot of what Superman looks like in the book. Flying next to Supergirl here, this is one of these shots near the end of the graphic novel. It really gives you a good idea of what Superman looks like. And in this shot from the first issue of the actual story, there's a really, really great close-up of Superman showing his eyebrows, jawline, really a great image of him. And as you can see, he looks slightly different. As I said, it's nothing too major. I do love this figure. It's a much better version. As I said, he's got much darker trunks and boots there, and the cape itself still has the S on the cape there, but it's a much more muted colour. So I'll just do a quick bit of articulation on this figure. As I said, it's identical to the one I did a few days ago. It's just a different paint scheme, but he does have a ball joint in the head. It will allow a full 360. It has very little movement up and down, to be honest, just very, very subtle. He has a ball joint in the arms, which is quite tight because I've barely moved them, but it does go out and in, forward and back. He has a bend at the elbow and a spin at the wrist. He has no waist articulation whatsoever, but his legs do go forward and back. Okay, I'm not moving them very much. I want to keep them quite tight. And he has a bend in the knee, and that's it. So very limited articulation, which once again is totally fine by me. What I'm going to do, I'm just going to put him back on his figure stand. With me. Okay, now he does have a slight raised leg, but he does stand perfectly fine. I mean, you can see this foot here is ever so slightly raised. I could fix that by putting it in boiling water. I just haven't done it yet. So, an awesome figure. What I am going to do is compare him to the original version. Now, obviously, I'm guessing you might agree which one is the better one. Obviously, it's each to their own, I suppose. But you can see here, here's the original version. Now, the original version does look slightly taller, but that's just because he's on a much higher base. You can see here, this S is so much better. This one kind of looks squashed or truncated or something, but this one obviously looks perfect. As you can see, it's the exact same figure. This one stands much better than this one. He has a bit bad case of kind of banana leg there. But what I'm going to do is just bring him a bit closer. In fact, I'll take them both off their bases. That'll be easier. Okay, so here you go. So you can, well, sorry guys, a bit hard to do this. So you can see the different paint schemes there. One is much darker than the other. And I do prefer the darker version, and the S is... If you bear with me. You can see here, this the S on the left just looks so much better. Like it's meant to be there. This one kind of just looks tacked on. The eyes are much darker as well. The blue they've used is totally different. Now on the back, you can see they both have the exact same S. You can see that you really see the difference in the paint scheme here. So, as I said, this one really is just a different paint sculpt or a different paint job, but I do prefer it over the original, to be honest. Okay, so that's the Superman from this set. Now, while I'm doing this, I'll just put him back up here. Just to confirm, this obviously, when it did come in a two-pack, of course, the Superman and the Supergirl, they also came with a graphic novel. So in addition to this Superman figure and the Supergirl, you also got the... Oops, in fact... Sorry guys, probably a little easier to see it this way. Yeah, it actually came with a full graphic novel, which they just called Superman, Batman, Supergirl. But it really is a brilliant read. Obviously, if you've seen my review, you've seen pretty much all the art that's in here. But it's just, I mean, you pick a page and there's gorgeous art. Anyway, it was really good to get the graphic novel along with the two figures. So the next figure I'm going to look at, of course, is the Supergirl. Now, this was the reason I bought the set, to be honest, because I saw this head sculpt and I absolutely had to have it. It looks so much better than the original version, which I'm going to compare it to. It looks so much prettier, I would say, to be honest. I'm just going to give her a full 360 on her own. She also has a much darker paint scheme. The cape, of course, the boots. The only real difference with regards to the paint scheme this figure has, in addition to the darker colours... is her collar line. Now in the original and in the book she has a yellow collar line, whereas this figure has omitted that, which, to be honest, I don't really care. It doesn't make a big difference. The S looks really, really good on this figure. So I'll just, once again, she comes with a standard black base, but just brilliant. Look at that face, it just looks great. Now she has got a little bit of red there. It looks a bit like a mole, to be honest, on the figure. It doesn't really bother me very much. It's from a distance, you very rarely see it. So it's just a brilliant head sculpt. I mean, look at that hair. Actually, the hair is almost attached in two parts here. There's a front section and a back section. But I really do like it. It looks so much more pretty than the original one. The colours being darker do work well. And of course, this figure stands, whereas the other one doesn't. She still has her foot on like a tiptoe there, you can see. But she at least stands. So on the back, it's the same cape. It's very, very floppy. It's very loose. It does have the nice yellow trim there, which I like. But the hair, look at the detail DC Direct have put into this hair, which is really rare. You know, when they do an alternate head sculpt, usually I find that they don't put this much work into it. But they've really outdone themselves with this one. Okay, so just... great. So what I'm going to do, I'll put her back on her base, which will of course help her stand, and I'm going to show you the original version. So as I said, if you've watched my reviews, you saw it a few days ago or saw it earlier, but here's the original. Hands down. This one looks so much better than this one. I can't pin it down. I mean, the dark blues look so much better. Obviously, this one looks a little taller because of the base, but the skin tone, this actually looks like a pinky skin tone. This is like a yellowy, sort of creamy colour. So I'll just bring it a little bit closer, just so you can compare the two, really. And to be honest, I don't think there's any comparison. Obviously, my light's not helping there. I'll just cover the light up. But I just think there's no comparison. This one, you know, just looks so faithful to the... I would say looks more faithful to the animated movie. There are a few scenes in the book where she does have her hair like this. But there are obviously a lot of scenes where it's kind of swept out to the side. But it's amazing what a different head sculpt can do for a figure. Okay, so I'm just actually going to... I'll see if I can actually find a part in the book. I think it's near the end where she actually has her hair like the figure on the left. There's a good example there. You know, obviously she's kind of got her hair in the middle parting there. So anyway, can't recommend that highly enough. Now, there was a strange thing to do with this set. Now, when I was actually trying to pick it up, I was kind of going around in circles. The reason being that even though... I'll just move this. Before I do this, sorry guys, I'm all over the place. I'm just going to do a quick 360 so you can compare the paint schemes. You can see, of course, the newer one has the darker cape. Oops, and this one's rotating. That doesn't help. Now, one thing I do like, I just noticed there as it was going around, is the gold. This Supergirl has a gold belt and gold trim. This one has like a really sort of pasty yellow trim. And you can see what I mean by the lack of yellow around the collar. It doesn't bother me at all. I didn't discuss articulation. It's exactly the same as the other figure. It has a ball joint. Now, it is severely limited, of course, by the hair. So you're actually going to get very little movement. Really just that and that. It will go forward and back ever so slightly. Arms are on a ball joint, which go out and in. The bend at the elbow, and of course her legs are very hampered by this part of the skirt here, and her knees do bend. So here's the articulation. Yeah, so just to get on to my previous point, I was having a lot of trouble tracking this one down. The reason... There goes the figure stand. The reason being that in all the promotional material, it is not this Superman they have pictured in the set. They actually have a totally different head sculpt. Now, this body has been used before and was actually used in the Identity Crisis line. Now, that's the next figure I'm going to do. But they use the exact same body type as this, as Superman, and they just changed the head sculpt. Now, whenever you try and find this online, it's the alternate head sculpt they used in all the promotion, but this was the only figure you got. And they also switched out the Supergirl. So whenever you looked at advertisements, sometimes the Supergirl had that head sculpt, sometimes it had this head sculpt, and this Superman, you know, it was a mix-mash. I think they just made a promotional mix-up, because when you do get it in package, these are the only two that you actually get. So I was looking at eBay auctions, and there was a seller who had the wrong image for the figures, and I asked him to send an actual picture. When he did, it was these two figures that were in the package, so I got it quite cheap. But if you guys are interested in getting this, I'm going to show you just now the sort of different options that they actually show advertising, and of course, so you can make sure you don't buy the wrong thing. And here's the main piece of promotional artwork that DC released for this set. And you'll notice, guys, that that is not the head sculpt that is on that figure at all. In fact, that's the head sculpt from a totally different figure, which is the Identity Crisis Superman. And you'll notice that the Supergirl they featured is the one from the single-carded version, which is, once again, not the one you get. Now, when I purchased this set on eBay, it was that promotional image, but when I asked the buyer for a picture of the actual item, this was the image he sent. And of course, here you can see the much better female head sculpt there, and you can see the darker paint scheme. It does have the original head there, of course, the one from my review, but this is the set you're looking for. So if you do see this image, this is the one you're wanting to get. Finally, I just thought I'd include an image of what Kara looks like in the animated movie, and you can see here that this version of the character is definitely what the sculptor was going for with this head sculpt and the two-pack. You'll notice also that Superman and Kara have darker suit paint schemes, so it really does make sense this was the look they were going for. Brilliant images. So there you go, guys. That was the Superman, Batman, Supergirl collector's set. It was actually released in November 2010, and I hope you enjoyed the review. If you have any questions or queries, or you'd like to ask any requests, you know, any review requests, then feel free to drop me a line. But I hope you've enjoyed the review, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Take care. Bye.